love that she was very honest. We learned a lot from it.
Tabitha is awesome!
She's very down to earth, and she speaks the truth, and it's awesome. I also loved her shoes.
I loved you, Tabitha, and thank you. I got a lot out of your show today, and I'm going to watch your show faithfully every week.
The challenge when I go in and take over someone's salon is that it's change and people don't really want to change.
Right.
Even though they know they have to change and they say they want to change, it's really hard to change. I mean, it's, you know, problem solution for me. You can't tell someone that something's wrong without giving them a solution of how to fix it.
Right.
So it's going in and saying, this isn't working in your business and I can see this and this is what I recommend that you do.
Okay.
And this is how I would approach it. And then, you know, tell them how to implement those steps and how to do it to make it their own and then actually follow through with it. I think the thing that I always find interesting about Canada whenever I come back, and I do come to Canada quite a lot, is that there's a lot of innovation here. People are very fashionable. They're fashion forward. They like to take risks, sometimes more than Americans do. So they play with their fashion more. They play with their hair more. They actually have more of an edge. Oh, my message for up and coming hairdressers is to never stop learning. You know, it's an industry that you can never stop getting education. There's always something new to learn. There's always ways to perfect your technique and what you do and do it better and hone it a little bit more and keep yourself fresh and current and relevant because trends change all the time. And, you know, as soon as you become complacent, it can be the kiss of death to your skill and also to your clients.